Growing up the way I grew up, like, my work ethic is, it's out the roof. For me, I wake up day in and day out knowing that I'm working hard to cement myself into history. Where I come from is from the South Side, I come from the hood. Like, I come from gun violence, police brutality, drugs, like, everything of that nature. Growing up in the neighborhoods that I did, like, you always, you know, chilling out with the guys, you know, doing sports and football, basketball, track, all those things, even running from dogs, you know? Like, you really learn how quick you really are. And then one day, you know, I was introduced to my coach. It became a point to where they seen that I could be a threat to the track and field world.
A real threat. And the 100 meters would become Trayvon Bromell's theater of dreams.
Great start from Bromell.
This is an event that holds a mythical status in sport. Can he become the fastest man on the planet? At the most recent IAAF World Athletics Championships, some of his unquestionable talent was finally brought to the track.
The World Championships, it was good to me. I definitely obviously wanted to go for gold under the circumstances of obviously being out of lane 8 and obviously my competitors who are also my comrade out in 3 and 4. When you're running, you can't see that far over. So it's like I never know where I am in the race.
They're away first time. There's a massive roar from the crowd. Coleman's going well out in lane 7. Still no move yet from Kerley. Bracy going well. Kerley's under pressure. It's so tight.
I mean, obviously, the competitor in me wants to win and wants to do great every time I step on the track, but also taking in the notion of what we did, sweeping the 100. I want to say it's probably only been done 2 times before us. So to be able to go out there and do that, it was memorable.
The American became the first junior to break the 10-second barrier, and he's got a healthy rivalry with his compatriots.
So when it comes to, like, creating interest through either rivalry, competitions, anything of that notion in track and field, it's crazy because the top guys are all USA. So people have seen recently, like, on Twitter, like, me, Marvin, and Fred made a bet, like, whoever can get into 9.6 first, and if we don't run that time that year, it rolls over to the next year. So we build our rivalry through that. So it's like, hey, you better be on your A game because, you know, I'm working hard to do this. And, you know, you will see the emotion at the meet. So we're going to be like, yeah, you know, talking trash at the end of the race. Like, hey, I need my money. We all want to run fast. You know, we all want to win gold. And I think people are going to see a shift of being able to get that entertainment back that they was able to be blessed with through, like, the Bolt era.
Bolt, Gay, Powell, 4, 5, and 6.
The next challenge, it's a big one, to run 9.6 seconds. As an elite athlete, how do you prepare and train to reach what is to many mission impossible?
9.58, smashing the world record, unbelievable!
To get to 9.6 is all about perfecting your craft. Obviously, we know only 2 men in history have ran 9.6, and only one has surpassed that. Once you get to a certain area or time, it now becomes more science. It's more about foot placement, about extension in, like, the hips, power force that you put into the ground. So we look at things like that because it is a science. So I don't, like, when people try to come with backlash, like, oh, man, you not know how fast 9.6 is. We know how fast 9.6 is, but we also know to get to this level, it is a science that can make it obtainable. The mental side is very important when it comes to this sport because you have the goal of wanting to say, hey, I want to be a world record holder. I want to be the greatest in this event. And we know that to be the greatest in this event, it comes with surpassing a time that's very, like, magical, mystical. We have to have that mental state to believe that we can break it. So I think people have to understand that sweet spot of saying, you know what? Let's actually entertain that this person think that they can break it, because what if?
Have faith in yourself and never give up.
I'm actually still learning on, you know, that mental prep. I turned pro in 2016, and I also got hurt in 2016. So I've been out of the sport and then came back in during 2020, during the COVID time, and then I didn't really start competing back on the circuit until 2021. So for me, I haven't learned mentally, like, how to attack being at the championship. Like, I really just be out there running like a kid. And I got a couple friends that called that. It was like, hey, if he gets back on the podium the next few years, be ready, because now he's going to understand what it takes to go get a medal. Now I have, because I got back on the podium, and I had to tell myself at that line, Trey, are you going to fail again, or are you going to go get a medal? So now that I know what it feels like to go get a medal, it's going to be interesting.
The secret to your success is in your daily routine.
Right now, my goals are obviously to run fast, but going forward, I just want to keep, you know, being one of the fastest men in history. Ultimately, obviously, winning Olympic goals and winning world championship goals. I don't want to lead a sport where individuals and people who love track and field don't know who I am, especially knowing how hard I work and everything that I've been through to stay in this sport and get back into this sport. I want people to remember what God has been able to put me in.